I'm gonna go get some coffee. You want something?
I want a big black one.
Okay, but what do you want to drink?
I want a big black one!
Well, I'm going to Starbucks, so you want a venti black coffee?
Well, I'm gonna smack you in the face. So, a big one, please. Ha.
Okay. If you think you can take it all, I'll get you a big black one.
I don't know what you're doing, big time. But if you don't go get me my big black coffee, ha, I will end you right here. You need to get latte.
Wait, so what are you gonna get?
A tall, hot blonde.
Gross. Yeah.
I bet 10.
I see your $10, and I raise you $2, big time.
I see your $2. And I also see you didn't put down a 10 to match my bet.
I see that this is a problem. And I see that this is really bothering you.
I see a lot of talking. Not a lot of putting the $10 in the pot.
I see your bank account sometimes. So I totally understand why you would be upset about this.
I see a ginger who's gonna put $10 in the pot right now. Or I see a ginger who's gonna get out of my car home and walk.
I see. Wait, you live in here? Gross.
I'm done. Taking my 10 back.
That's smart, cause I had seen your cards like the whole time. Pair of twos, so read them and weep.
If it ain't about money, you can miss me with it.
Y'all, I want to talk about something close to my heart. Wieners. Where do I put this? Not those kind of wieners, you nasty. Get your mind out of the gutter. Talking about hot dogs. Why are there so many wiener options at Walmart? There's... it puts my brain into wiener overload, okay? My brain can't process that much wiener, okay? God did not make the human brain to be able to process 15 different types of wiener, okay? My brain can only process about 2. One being original, the other one being, why did you put something in that hot dog? Okay, that's about it. So I was in Walmart, okay? Looking at wieners, like I do. Y'all are not gonna believe the flavored wieners that I saw, okay? First off, I saw the flavor chicken and apples.
Why? What?
Does it even taste like wiener anymore? Why don't y'all just make a coffee-flavored wiener and put it in my coffee mug every morning? If your life is so boring that you have to spice it up by buying flavored wieners, y'all need to have like a game night or something. Y'all can call me. I'm a hoot.
Chicken and apple-flavored wiener. That's y'all's president right there,
okay? Y'all voted for him, and now he's making wiener options out the wazoo. I can't keep up with all the wiener options. Thanks, Trump. I walk in expecting to see one wiener, okay? I see 15 wieners. That's a lot of wiener, okay? Too many wieners for me to count. Ain't nobody got time for all them wieners, okay? Y'all, if I don't put the clip of me breaking the spoon, then this is gonna look really weird for the rest of the video. I have more spoons. I'm not a monster. Just gotta rummage through my homelessness to get there. And do y'all think God's happy that y'all making all these different types of wieners? Wrong. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Okay? It don't say in the beginning God created 15 different types of wieners. Someone please show me where in the Bible it says that God looked down upon the 15 different types of wieners and saw that it was good. No, God looked down upon the 15 different types of wieners and saw that it was too many wieners. That's what I'm trying to tell y'all. I broke my spoon, y'all! No! If I'm having a barbecue and someone brings me chicken and apple flavored wiener, I'm gonna smack them in the forehead with that wiener, okay? You're gonna have all kinds of bruises on your forehead from that wiener. Wiener bruises. I only got the stomach for about two wieners. What if I eat one of your chicken and apple wieners and it's not good? Then I get one more shot, okay? And I go back to the original. Shoot, I grabbed another chicken and apple. Now I'm full on nasty, nasty wiener. God forbid, you know?
What's the continuity error?
I don't know. Living in your car in the summer really ruins things. The problem is, living in my car with these black seats, if something was a solid, now it's a liquid, okay? It has shifted its molecular structure into something that I don't even need no more. For example, I'm pretty sure that the big dogs over there at Jiffy didn't want me to have to pour my peanut butter all over my wheat bread, which has now become soggy, soggy wheat water, okay? I can't just put them all into a cup and drink it. Nobody wants to drink a peanut butter sandwich, all right? I done bought me some fruit in a cup. Granted, I forgot I bought it and it sat in the back for a while, but it exploded. It exploded. That means the sun ate my fruit, okay? First off, don't let the sun know what you're eating, okay? That's ungodly. Okay, and another thing, listen, why the heck is my chapstick melting, and then every time I turn my car on with the air conditioning, it solidifies back into place, and now it's in this weird spot. Every time I try to twist my chapstick back up, it's like, You ain't chapstick no more, okay? You done melted. You changed your molecular structure, okay? You was a solid. Now you's a liquid. Not my chapstick. Hashtag, not my chapstick. I have to sit my sweaty butt down on these black leather seats, okay? So anytime I have to go to the bathroom or go get something to eat, I gotta rip these sweaty car seat band-aids off my butt cheeks, okay? That's not what God intended for my life. Child. Y'all listen to me, okay? I have a few things to say about this situation. I have to make sure that I don't eat any foods with sodium whatsoever, or I will turn into a literal grape. Okay? A grape. Y'all heard me the first time. Everything I own now is a liquid. Okay? Things that weren't supposed to be liquids are now liquid. Okay? I've had shirts that turn into a puddle. Okay? I'm able to melt down nickels in this heat, okay? And I will. If melting down nickels is gonna get me out this heat, I'm gonna melt down nickels, okay? I tried to write my mama a handwritten letter, that paper turned straight into liquid water, okay? Now y'all got me all worked up, and now I gotta go shower, because now I'm sweating mentally, sweating physically, and sweating everywhere else. I have literal butt sweats that will give you nightmares, okay? The inside of my ears are sweating. Where's that water coming from? Where's it go? What does it want from me? This sun's heat is literally changing the way bodies work, okay? I'm surprised I don't even turn to a liquid. Do you know my body's made up of 60-something percent of water? That's scary. If I sit out in the sun too long, I'm gonna turn into a boiling pot of, what is that? Let me tell you what it's like to take a nap in your car. In the middle of summer in California, okay? Now, imagine, just picture this for me real quick one time. Imagine you pull out a lawn chair, okay? You set it up. You got a nice gentle breeze going. And then you throw yourself into an active volcano. My mama raised me to be a grateful sumbee, but I ain't gonna be grateful today. I'm gonna be a great big pile of sweaty butt cheeks, if you know what I'm talking about. Okay, first off, me and the sun, we don't get along, okay? I used to live in Alaska, hence the unique shade of white on my entire body. The problem is, if I want to wear shorts and I want to wear a tank top, the sun's going to notice I ain't one of them and attack me first, okay? I'm going to look like a lobster. I'm going to look like a cheesy biscuit basket from Red Lobster, okay? Hashtag shaking my head. Hashtag sweat going everywhere. I have animals flocking to my body thinking that I'm a body of water. Let me tell y'all how bad it is right now, okay? I bought some mayo so I could have me a mayo mustard sandwich. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Hashtag delish. I bought mayo. Put it in my car. It's tan. Okay? It's so hot that my mayo developed a tan. My mayo is more tan than I am right now. Explain that to me. My mayonnaise is so tan now that I have to call it mayonnaise. Y'all don't worry though, because I bought a lottery ticket and I'm going to see if I'm going to get out of this car still homeless. It's not even a lottery ticket. Rip this off my creamer. I'm sick and tired of having friends come over and they tell me stories about their life and I'm listening to them, but I got sweat running into my eyeballs so I can't really listen. I'm just doing this right here and I'm like, looking like I'm having a stroke and they can't concentrate. I can't concentrate. We end up just sweating in each other's presence, okay? We don't even talk no more. We just sweating. You ever been in weather that's so hot that you literally cannot speak? You have to physically conserve your energy so that your body can create sweat. I don't think y'all understand. It's hot in here. What the heck is that? A blemish? Could be worse. Doubt it. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. My biggest fear in life is that I'm gonna melt into a sweat puddle and be evaporated into the clouds. Oh my God, I cannot even imagine what that would be like, okay? Rest in peace. Hashtag rest in peace to all the people who've been melted into a sweat puddle and then evaporated into the clouds. I've been living in my car for over a year, okay? I started off with a dog. Guess where the dog went? I don't know. The dog got evaporated into a sweat puddle. Now he's in the clouds, and every time it rains, I try to get a little cup so maybe he'll solidify back into a little puppy dog. It don't work that way, and neither does ChapStick. Dear God, do I gotta keep bringing up the ChapStick for y'all to realize how bad my situation is? Why on earth did I choose black leather seats? I saw these black leather seats. My first reaction was, wow, those are hot. Literal words I used. How accurate was I? It says it's 104 outside, but I believe it. Dear Lord. Maybe y'all would like to know what it's like to sit your bare thighs down on some black leather Band-Aid seats. It's nice. Y'all like sarcasm? If it gets any hotter, dear Lord, I may just die. Y'all, I moved down here in my car so that I could follow my dreams, okay? I didn't know I'd have to swim there. There is so much sweat on my lower back, I could rent out my lower back to kids' parties as like a kiddie pool, profit, and get myself into a proper home. Okay, y'all, it's starting to get real hot at night when I'm going to sleep, and I can only take off so much clothes before the Lord looks upon me with disapproval. So, your move, son. My laundry is done, so I'm gonna go so I can get myself out of this desert island of a parking lot and go somewhere that's covered, okay? Maybe find someone that'll open their home to me for the night. Not, like, let me stay there, but physically open the door so I can feel the draft of the air conditioning, okay? I have nothing else to say, so. Why do people jiggle door handles when I'm in the bathroom? And I'm not talking just like a gentle little jiggle, see if someone's in there. No, I'm talking about the people who jiggle the life purpose out of the door handle. Like the only purpose that door handle had in life is gone. I'm sitting on the pot. I'm doing the business that God intended for me to do alone. If I am sitting on the toilet and you pop the lock out on me, my body immediately goes into fight or flight mode, okay? Unfortunately for me, my body can't do either of those things. Not at that moment. I only have two options. Option number one is to finish really quick. Unlikely. Option number two, I could get up, do that little duck squat thing where you can only sidestep 3.5 inches at a time till I get to the door and pop the lock back in. But that's risky though. Because if you think it's embarrassing getting caught sitting on a toilet, then you've never been caught mid-bathroom sitting on no toilet with your butt cheeks hanging out in front of the Lord. If your butt cheeks are hanging out in front of the Lord, first off, sinner. Secondly, you're vulnerable, okay? Everybody knows that, all right? That's biblical. I don't care if you're 6'7", 290 pounds, trained in Krav Maga. If I walk in on you and you're duck squatting with your butt cheeks hanging out, not on the alpha male, okay? I'm top dog, okay? You're still trying to hold on to the front of your pants with one of your hands. I have full use of both of my arms. Also, I can stand up. Huge advantages for me, okay? What are you gonna do? Your only line of defense at this point is that little arm wavy motion, like, hey, get out of the bathroom. What are you gonna do with that, okay? It takes 15 pounds of pressure to break a kneecap. You can't possibly muster enough momentum to pull off that maneuver. Not in that position. I don't know how much it takes to break a kneecap. when you're in that position, your center of gravity is way the heck over there, okay? I have your center of gravity. I now have two different centers of gravity, okay? I could knock you over with the gentlest of breezes, okay? If I close the door too fast, you're falling over in that little pee puddle over there, okay? I have that kind of power. Do I use it? No. Because I realize you won't always be in this position, and this seems like something worth holding a grudge over. That's all I have to say.
First question we're always asking is, what do I really want? What's my outcome? And then we get down to what...
For Angel?
Yes. Do you mind getting in the back?
Sure.
Sorry. The backpack.
You mean the trunk?
But it's a hatchback, but yeah, the trunk, whatever.
Most people are achieving their outcomes, they just don't realize their outcomes are so general that they're achieving them.
In here?
Yeah, just crawl, like, yeah, just up in here. Just crawl in there. Never been in a car before?
Dozens of times. I don't think I'm gonna fit in here.
Huh?
I'm pretty tall. I'm 6'2". This is meant for someone 5'11".
You know what? This happens all the time. I got you. Hold on.
The blanket in here? What the hell?
Oh, you'll fit. Just, like, feet. Hold on.
Yeah. Ah! Oh, that's
something?
Yeah, my foot!
Yeah, you're gonna have to curl that in.
Ah! Stop, I swear, it's not gonna fit. You probably fit here, I don't.
You are a giant. Put that leg over there.
Alright,
let's go.
No. There's a full-on bed in your car.
Oh, right, that's for your comfort.
What about my safety?
Oh, it's basically all memory foam. So if we do get in a wreck, I mean you're... Whoops, excuse me. Just...
I feel that.
Right? I feel it too.
Memory foam, yeah, I remember this.
We got a good connection. Hmm?
Yo, do you live in here?
No. I don't live in...
Are you sure?
Yes. Yes, positive.
There's pillows. There's a blanket. Was this piss?
Hmm? It's apple juice. Oh, be careful. It's not...
Just ask for the 5 stars. It's not that...
I'm not... It's apple
juice. That's urine.
Mm.
That's nasty.
It's...
Why is it in an Arrowhead bottle? Who drinks Arrowhead?
It's expired, but it's definitely not piss. Okay, it's piss. You from here?
Don't change the subject. You live in your car.
Mm-mm.
What are you...
It's not... I don't... I...
You've
in
got
here
gain
for...
in here.
That's...
Why do you have gain in here? People have this in their laundry room at home.
That's like an air freshener.
So you live in your car?
I don't live... can I make a left up here?
Yeah. What is this? You live in your car.
I don't live
you
in
definitely
I don't
live
in,
car.
In my car.
What do you do with this? What are people supposed to do with this?
What else do you do with the case? You put your phone in it.
But why is it on your ceiling?
Great question. Can I make a right up here?
Yeah. 10 ways to live in your car. You live in your car.
That was a gift.
From who?
A friend?
What friend?
Bill.
You live in your car.
I don't live...
10 ways to live in your car. Where'd you get this at?
Bill.
Who's Bill? Is Bill homeless?
Bill has a house.
Everything in here is highlighted.
Can I make a write up there?
There's a confirmation number next to it. Did you order this on Amazon?
I did. What? What?
It has
Amazon.
A name of where to put it on Amazon. You ordered this.
I.
You live in your car.
I don't even have an address.
You live in a. You live in your car.
I don't.
You live in your car.
Can I have 5 stars?
I'm gonna give you 4 now.
Can I make a write?
Go ahead.
Yeah.
You live in your car.
I don't. A little.
How do you a little live in your car?
It's not like I...
It's like me saying I little got my girlfriend pregnant. Just a little bit.
I understand that. A little bit pregnant. That makes sense. I'm just trying to make some money on the side. But people keep giving me 2 stars.
I wonder why.
Because I keep forgetting to put away my piss bottle. I mean, apple juice.
Oh my lord.
It says I can save 4 minutes if I take an alternate
route. Please.
Can
please
I?
Save all.
But I have to take a right up here.
Nothing new. You're making a left.
Oh, I just realized I'm dropping you off at the car dealership. What are you gonna get?
Well, I'm not shopping for a home now, am I?
That's hurtful and rude.
Because you live in your car.
Semi-accurate.
Can I go in the front?
No. No, you...
Why?
Just... No.
Why can't I go... I'm going in the front.
No, you can't. You just stay back.
I'm not staying here.
Just stay back.
Why can't I go in the front?
You
why can't
stay...
I... Really? Really?
Can I make a left up here?
You're making a right!
All right. I think that went really well.
Open the back.
Right. Yeah.
Just gonna want to get out, make a left, and
I hate when everybody just thinks because I'm a performer that I don't have stage fright. You're wrong. I do. It's bad. Okay? I'm talking about being in stressful situations and not being able to handle it. They say stress will kill you faster than anything in the world, but I think a cannonball to the chest would disagree. I get stressed out, nervous, if I know people are watching me and I pick the wrong size lid for my Dr. Pepper. I just act like I meant to grab a small lid for my medium cup, okay? Just Dr. Pepper going everywhere. What do you do at that point? Do you throw it away? Do you put it back? I don't know lid etiquette, okay? If there's a line forming behind me and I'm standing at the urinal trying to pee, I will never pee, okay? I will die of an erupted bladder before... Is that where your bladder's at? I don't know. I will pee internally before I pee externally. I'm stressed. A little. Not a lot. Okay, a lot. It's alright. It's not great. I'll get over it. I might. I won't. It's pretty bad. I don't need help. Okay? Thank you. Let me tell you guys the story of the first time I really used the law of attraction. I think I was like 16 years old, living with my aunt, my uncle, and my cousins in Arkansas. One day we were all at the house, and I think we were having like a barbecue or something. We had a bunch of people over, and someone left the door open and their dog got out. They had a little Boston Terrier. Cute. I hated her, but she was cute. But I hated her, but she was cute. So my aunt was a little worried about it. Also, we lived literally maybe 100 feet from the highway. We didn't really notice she was gone until like a couple hours later. And she started asking if we'd seen the dog, and we were like, no, I haven't seen her, because I don't look for her. I hate her. The sun's going down at this point. It's getting dark. The dog hasn't come back. Her name was Molly, I think. Like I said, I hated her. At this point, it's dark. Dog hasn't come home. My aunt is in tears. And, like, we all just decide to go to bed. I decided to do the law of attraction, or what I knew from it. Number one, I have to act as though the dog is already here, that the dog is already safe. So I knew that I had to act as though the dog was already there. So I poured a bowl of food. I was going to say cereal. I didn't pour the dog a bowl of cereal. And so I slept on the couch in the living room because I knew she was going to come to this certain door. Like, it wasn't hopeful, it was a knowing. It was the weirdest feeling I've ever felt in my life. It was this deep gut knowing, like, she's gonna come to this door, and I need to be at this couch. I can't even explain it to this day about that feeling. So the next day, I woke up, and they told me that she got hit on the highway and died. It didn't work. I didn't do it right. If my aunt is watching this, I'm so sorry for this video. I guess I didn't love her enough because she died. I'm pretty sure immediately. So that's my law of attraction story. I'm sorry. There's an ant in my car. Speaking of ants, that was my aunt in ant form because I killed her dog. How ironic. I killed it. Just like that car killed her dog. I'm so sorry. My home is in the shop, okay? My car decided to start smoking, okay? It's a nasty habit, bad habit. And I showed her what's what, and I took her into the shop, and I said, hey, she needs to stop this smoking right now. I don't care what y'all gotta do, okay? I'll pay whatever I gotta pay. You get her to quit that habit, okay? Meantime, I'm in a tiny, tiny little car, okay? It's little. I'm little. Doesn't matter. We're both little. Still little. Doesn't matter. Okay, it matters. Listen, I have to sleep here, okay? You understand what I'm trying to say to you? I don't even know how I'm going to do it. Just lay my seat back. Wow. That goes all the way. This is a bed. This is how I'm doing the video, okay? I always apply my mayo laying completely horizontal, okay? Does this look sexual? That's a lot of mayo. Or is it not enough, okay? Think about that. You know how Walmart has like those little samples that they hand out? It's always like an old woman, old white woman in her 50s, who's just standing there with a blue apron on. And she's like, you wanna try this? And then has a toothpick in it. They had that there. Except normally when I go, it's normally something like, try our new teriyaki chicken, okay? Try this new flavor of cheese. This lady was just cutting strawberries, okay? Who doesn't know what a strawberry tastes like? Who needs a sample of a quarter of a strawberry for them to realize they need to buy strawberries? No one, okay? I answered it for you. You don't even gotta answer it. Let me take a bite real quick. I did get this really nice white chocolate mocha Starbucks coffee though. I opened this sucker and it was to the top, okay? It was leveled off. It's like they filled it to the top, but like 2 inches above. Then they cut it off and leveled it, okay? They made a liquid hover 2 inches above the cap and they cut it off. I don't know how Starbucks does it, but they are geniuses. This sandwich is delicious, okay? I'm not gonna lie. It looks dry because it is, but that's what the mayo's for, okay? This happens to me almost every time I go into Walmart, okay? I'm walking down an aisle and I'm chewing, okay? And I'm chewing this sandwich right here. And now I'm gonna talk in a second. So I'm walking down the aisle at Walmart, okay? And someone else is walking against traffic, okay? They're coming at me, I'm coming at them, okay? I give them plenty of time. I let my body language tell them, hey, I'm gonna make a severe left right here, okay? Shift my body and start walking that way, making a cut, okay? You know I'm gonna cut here. I'm gonna make a left so you pass on my right, okay? That's just how it works. I'm gonna go on the left here, okay? You're gonna go around me the other way. I've already established the lanes here for us, okay? I've made a decision executively for us both. I've never run into so many people than when I'm at Walmart, okay? You don't actually run into the people, okay? It's more like you get 2 feet away from them and then you both do that sidestep at the same time. Like, I'll go right. No, I'll go right, okay? And then you're like, So now y'all got this Mexican standoff without no Mexican, without no third party, okay? So it's technically just two white people staring at each other in the middle of Walmart. I'm just gonna either start wearing a blinker and or just audibly saying out loud which way I'm gonna go. Big old lady with the tank top on and the shorts that are pants? I don't know. I'm coming on your left, okay?
Walmart.
And then they ran out of bags. Y'all forgot to order peanut butter? Understandable. Y'all have like 15 bazillion things y'all sell. But bags? But why? I had to carry all my goodies out in the open so people could see what I bought, okay? It's embarrassing. I need my privacy. I need my purchase privacy, okay? Walmart, you have eliminated my purchase privacy. And I am very upset, okay? Also, I'm overdramatic right now because I'm in a new car. I don't know what I'm gonna do, where I'm gonna sleep. But this coffee's real good because it was all the way to the top, leveled off. I don't even taste the mayo in this. What does that say about me? I do love mayo. I know that's stereotypical, but it's also correct, okay? I feel really bad for those people who are like really grossed out by the sight of people eating or the sound of people eating because there's a lot going on in this video, okay? A lot to swallow, literally, okay? This is just a normal car. This is just a normal sandwich. I'm just a normal man who's going to sleep in a normal car with a stomach full of normal sandwich, okay? But with a really, really not normal Starbucks drink. Because they filled it 2 inches above us, leveled it off at the top. This is an unnecessary amount of lettuce, okay? I feel like the next couple nights are going to be super lonely, okay? I don't have my emoji pillow. I don't have my other little pillows to keep me company, okay? I don't have the ants. I miss the ants, okay? That's what I'm trying to get at with this video. Why y'all think I've been slinging lettuce everywhere? Y'all want to have a sleepover? Just come over. I'll pile as many of y'all in here as I can, okay? We'll conserve body heat even though it's 197 degrees outside. I may just not go to bed, okay? That has been a thought of mine. Oh, y'all, I'm famous. Okay, I'll explain. Someone hit me up in my DMs the other day, okay? I went over there, I allowed the message so we could chit-chat. But all she did was send a photo, okay? Guess what? Yeah, a nude. She sent me a nude. I got a nude yesterday, okay? That means I'm successful. That means I'm famous. I'm done. No more videos. Sorry, if y'all enjoy these videos, that's too bad, okay? I've reached the pinnacle of where I needed to be. The sandwich represents the pinnacle. My mouth represents
something.
She did not say one word to me, okay? It was just like, boobies. And then I was like, wow, okay? It was a shock to me, first off. And after that picture looped 17 times, okay, I blocked her, okay? Okay, it didn't loop 17 times, maybe 3, okay? I had to make sure it wasn't a scam. Probably was. Blocked her anyway. Anywho, I got a nude. Hey, y'all need to stop changing the subject and come back to what's happening here, okay? Got a nude. Successful. I'm a man, okay? I'll admit it. You send me boobies, suddenly I'm interested, okay? But you gonna have to put some words within boobies, okay? You're gonna have to give me some context before the boobies, okay? You can't go boobies in context. No, they don't work like that, okay? The proper steps of sending a nude, okay, are step one, don't do it. Step two, pray. Step three, give your life back to God, you sinner, okay? I have never seen someone that naked in my entire life, okay? I don't even shower that naked. That's how naked she was, okay? I couldn't even tell you what her face looked like because I call the last 24 hours of my life a win, okay? Gone. Time. 22 minutes. Personal best. LA is beautiful. Except I'm looking directly at a stone wall. Hi. Happy to be me. Happy to see you. Happy to be here. Happy to be with you. I'm gonna teach you how to draw a happy bird, okay? Happy birds. I don't even have to look. To make a happy bird, it's very simple. You're gonna start from here. And you're gonna think about McDonald's. But you're gonna think opposite, okay? And from here, you're gonna get your mind out of the gutter, okay? And after you get your mind out of the gutter, then we're gonna make a happy bird, okay? Hi, welcome back. Hopefully your mind is all purified and not thinking of nasty things. Let's continue. In order to continue making a happy bird, you have to become the happy bird, okay? In order to become a happy bird, you have to feel like a happy bird. Like that. From here, you're just gonna wanna make eyes on the bird, okay? This does turn into a bird, I promise. In order to finish making a happy bird, what you're gonna have to do is come here. There we go. If you wanna make your bird more unique and give it arms, all you have to do, simple as that.
I ain't even sorry that I'm sweaty and dirty. I had to clean my car. I had an ant infestation. There's one now! I'm hoping that this car wash will act kind of like a baptism, wash away all the sins. Sins, of course, being the dirty little infestation ants that came into my car last night. They're sneaky.
What I like to do at night is back my car all the way up against these bushes to where the back window right there is just like right there with the bushes. That way I don't gotta put a blanket over it. I could just sleep butt naked. Problem was, I backed all the way up to the curb. My wheel touching the curb. I'm not doing a great job with my hand visualization. This is the curb. This is my car. I backed all the way up to it. The ants crawled onto the car tire all the way up. I rolled down my windows. It was 118 degrees last night. It's like I woke up to a lesbian family reunion, okay? Ants everywhere. No uncles in sight, just ants. There's still ants in here, okay? I'm just avoiding them. Oh my God, this morning it was so embarrassing. I had to pick up my friend, take him to work with me, okay? These ants were like, decided that they should sit in the passenger seat and not him. I picked him up and he's sitting over here on this passenger side seat, and he's telling me a story, and as he's telling me a story, I see these ants, okay? They're plotting. They're scheming. I'm not even listening to his story anymore. I couldn't tell you what he was talking about. These ants were crawling across the dashboard. They made a beeline for him, okay? They were like, okay, we're gonna attack him now. He's telling the story. There's ants crawling across the dashboard. I see him crawling up his pant leg. He don't know. He can't feel it. So I have to make a bold move and grab his knee and say, listen, that's a good story, but I was squishing the ants, okay? There was a handful of ants underneath my hand and on his leg that I smashed like that. And I bring my hand back and I put it in my pocket, okay? Handful of ants, dead ants. It was a massacre. And then I notice where they're actually coming from, okay? His window, all right? So I'm freaking out because if he looks over and he sees the line of ants just flooding in his window, trying to get to him and whatever in his pockets. I don't know if he has sweets unwrapped in his pockets, but he better watch out because he's going to get attacked by these lesbian ants. I had to make a move and I had to make it quick, okay? So I rolled his window down ever so slightly so he didn't even notice. Turned on my windshield wiper fluid, let the windshield wipers go haywire, and flood out ants. Got him wet in the process, but guess what? I'd rather him say, hey, there's water all over me than, why are there a bunch of lesbian ants all over me, okay? I had to prioritize. I knew something was gonna get on him. It better be fluid. I'm gonna keep that in the video. I don't know how to get rid of ants properly. I sprayed them with this. Febreze. I saw a Chinese army of ants coming to my car this morning, okay? Through my window. A group of them. The front line, they were trying to attack, okay? They were on the attack. But so was I, okay? I soaked them with Febreze, and then they didn't move for a while. And I guess they dried up or something, because it's hot outside, and they just kept marching, okay? I admire their hard work and diligence, but I'd admire them a lot better if they just die. I remember when I was a little boy, I spilled a whole bunch of crackers on the floor. I didn't want to clean them up. I put my jeans over them. Obviously, it's what you do. Okay? If mom don't see the mess, mom don't make you clean the mess, okay? That should be a t-shirt. But the next morning, my mom found the mess, okay? And not only did she find a mess, she found a mess of ants on top of that mess, okay? Two layers of messes, okay? One being a live layer of ants, okay? The other one just being crackers, okay? They're hauling crackers out through my closet door. Last night, I was eating a Chef Boyardee straight from the can. I didn't throw it away, and I didn't eat it all, so I'm kind of thinking that's why they're in the car. So I threw that out, step one. Step two, got them with the Febreze. Step three, rejoice, okay? You've won. I have conquered ant land. Next year, at the family reunion, it's just gonna be a bunch of uncles, okay? Because all the ants are dead. Ants are probably still back there scheming. Probably just reproducing and scheming. Babies, and then hey, this is what we're gonna do. Babies, and then the babies are reproducing, and then they're planning, and then those babies are reproducing, and they're planning. I'm never gonna get rid of these ants, all right? Oh my God, there's so many ants. 1, 2, 3,000. Oh my God. What am I gonna murder me? Someone kill God, if you love me at all, kill me right now. I wish. Okay. Yes, Lord. I hear you calling. I give my life to you, Lord. Please wash over me with your love. Let your angels surround about me, Lord, and please kill all the ants in the world. So this is what freedom feels like. Wow. Thank you, Lord. I feel like a new man. No commitments to no ants, nowhere. Is that a bee? I see one crawling on my mattress. Hold on. Ah. Okay, y'all, they're back and they're stronger, okay? I wish I was kidding to make a great video, but I'm not, okay? I'm infested with ants, part two. Y'all, here's what happened. Yesterday, felt like a new man, got a car wash, vacuumed out my car, real nice, felt clean, okay? Went to bed, woke up this morning. Oh my God, if I thought I had a lot of ants, I was wrong, okay? I was dead wrong. I was alive wrong. I literally wanted to vomit in my mouth. That's how many ants there were, okay? There were a vomit in my mouth amount of ants on my center console, okay? I'm gonna give y'all a little insight into living in your car, okay? When you live in your car, the main food groups are bread and peanut butter, okay? It's been 117 degrees nearly every day, okay? My peanut butter melted a little and I felt it. And a little bit of the juices came out onto the bottle, okay? Onto the jar. There's a little bit of juice on the jar, okay? I put it back. I didn't think nothing of it. I opened the door, and I counted way too many ants to be in my car, okay? It was like black, just large black groups of movement. They weren't even ants anymore, okay? They were movement. I saw one carrying a piece of chip this big, okay? Actual size. Crawling, just trying to take it away. I said no, grabbed it, threw it out the window to make an example. Y'all don't know how mad I was this morning. I was gonna film it and show y'all, but I was too mad saying the Lord's dirty words that I couldn't even get to my phone to record it, okay? There's more in here. I can feel their presence, okay? I don't feel at ease in my heart, okay? That's how I know those little devils are still alive. This morning, I woke up about 30 minutes before I had to be at work, okay? And I realized that I was being infested part two, and then I was like, why? I threw everything away. Everything. I threw my peanut butter away. I littered it, actually. That's how mad I was, y'all. I don't litter. I put it on the ground and I said bye, and I didn't even look back, okay? So if y'all find like a jar of Skippy peanut butter with honey in it, that was me, and I'm sorry. How am I supposed to attract a suitable mate if people keep seeing ants all over me, okay? People gonna think I'm dirty. I ain't dirty, okay? Y'all just rude. I went to the car wash, got that vacuum, and I sucked them all up, okay? But there was a few left. So I decided to leave them. I threw everything out in my car. Anything that was edible. I don't care what it was. If you could eat it, threw it away. And then I went to work. Now I'm off work. And now I'm killing ants one by one. The temperature in this car is way too perfect, okay? I cannot let them enjoy the temperature of this car. I'm going to put it all the way down to 60. Are you inside the car or are you outside the car? Okay, you're outside. I'm gonna kill you anyway. There were so many ants, okay? They moved my shoes, okay? They moved my shoes to get to my peanut butter. That's what I thought. They're all showing up right here where the dirty rag is. I think they're trying to save their Are they reviving the ant? Oh my God, they're respawning. This is like a horrible game of Halo. Or some other game where you respawn. I'm homeless, I don't play games. The only game I get to play is kill the ant with a tissue and cry later because you're infested. I'm done, ants. Y'all can have my car. Y'all can have my life. I do not care. I don't care. My credit cards are in my wallet. My wallet is over there. I'll buy y'all peanut butter later. Just kill me. Eat me first. I love graffiti. I think it's super neat. Hopes. Tapes. USC. Murder group. Okay, not as much of a fan anymore. The minute y'all start graffitiing the words murder group, that ain't even a clever name. Who names their gang murder group? Like, that sounds so dumb. I don't want to, like, publicly make fun of y'all. Because, I mean, your title literally says y'all murder people in groups. Wait, do y'all murder people in groups or do y'all murder groups? Is it, like, one guy who's just, like, murdering groups? Or is it a group of guys murdering, like, one person? I have questions, okay? Murder group, please reach out to me. My phone number is 818. Do not call me. I'm one of those people who don't like to use their blinker when they merge, but I'm also one of those people who get really mad when people don't use their blinker to merge. also known as a hypocrite. I'm what people call an aggressive merger. I don't like to give anybody any notice at all, even myself. I just like to do it. I just like to be there, okay? I don't like the journey. I just want to be in the other lane. If I could teleport to the lane next to me, I'd do it, okay? Y'all, I hate it when someone doesn't tell you when you have something stuck on your face all day. I was at work today, okay? I went to the bathroom towards the end of the day, and I looked in the mirror, and guess what I saw? I saw a sprig of parsley stuck to my forehead right there, okay? Plain as day. Plain as day right there. I'm not talking about minced parsley. I'm not talking about a leaf of parsley. I'm talking about a sprig of parsley, okay? Where it's a leaf with a stem and another leaf, okay? A sprig. It's, oh my Lord, how many people saw that sprig and didn't say nothing to me? Y'all wanna know what makes it even worse? The company that I work for hired videographers to come in today, okay? I was excited. I was gonna be on film, okay? This was my break, my 15 minutes. I'm gonna be famous. They didn't film me. Y'all wanna know why? Of course it was the parsley. Y'all know how many friends I talked to face to face today? Parsley sprig to face? Zero. You wanna know why? Cause a friend would tell you if you had a parsley sprig stuck to your forehead right here. How are you not gonna say, hey, you have a vegetable on your head? Thank you. How long has it been there? We've just had a 10-minute conversation and you're telling me now? Have you even been listening to what I'm saying? Y'all mean to tell me y'all didn't see the massive food group attached to my forehead today? Okay, not only did we have videographers there today, the president of the company, my boss, my boss's boss, and the DO, and supermodels because they were in the videos. Guess who wasn't in the videos? Oh, vegetable face over here. That really pees me oh, okay? This is literally how every conversation should have went today. Hi, how are you? I'm good, how are you? I'm great, you got parsley on your face. Awesome, thank you. What, were y'all afraid of embarrassing me by telling me I got a vegetable on my forehead? You know what's more embarrassing than telling me I got a vegetable on my forehead? Finding out that I've had a vegetable on my forehead for over 8 hours. Yo, I'm literally gonna die. That thing just flew in my car. Holy crap balls. Don't worry, I got a shoe. My heart's pounding out my chest. I feel like someone's got a gun to my head, but instead of a gun, it's a giant bait. If I could just park somewhere, I could jump out of my car and flee, okay? No pun intended. He's looking at me. Oh my God. I figured if I just keep talking nervously like I'm doing, you'll leave or stay put, and then I'll leave. I don't care who leaves as long as I'm not around you. Ran a red light. You are shimmering in the light. I got ants, but I ain't got these things, okay? Holy crap, I just remembered I have Raid in my car. I'm shaking. You see me shaking? He says it kills ants and cockroaches. This is like a mixture of the two. I don't think he's gonna like this one bit if I sprayed him. He's stumbling. Maybe I should get him one more time. Oh, he's going. I will get you from back here, sir. Oh yeah, that was a good one. Okay. What have I done? He's attacking. He's attacking. The problem with that plan was I don't know where he went, okay? Of all the surface area of LA. A lot of good you did, Shu. With no help to me. That thing was gigantic, okay? That was a rhinoceros beetle. I don't know for sure. I'm just making up names that sound appropriate. Oh, y'all. I'm glad I recorded it, because if I would have died, y'all would have been like, why? Then they would have said, oh, a little beetle got him. No, but now y'all know the truth, okay? A gigantic moon beetle attacked me first, okay? I was just defending myself. For all of y'all who are like, why would you spray him? It was either that or the shoe, okay? Which one's worse? Probably the Raid. I'm not sorry. He came in here flapping his wings. I thought a helicopter was above me, okay? Till I found out that a giant gorilla beetle just jumped into my window. What was he thinking? Does he really think I'm gonna let a gigantic hippo beetle stay in my car? No, okay? I barely would let tiny little ants stay in my car. Holy crap. What if the ants are just bringing friends over now? Then again, why would ants be friends with a gigantic Kim Jong-un beetle? Lord, please reveal to me what I am doing to attract gigantic Hummer beetles. Okay? And ants. Okay, y'all would have done the same thing if a Bengal tiger beetle leaped into your car window like that, okay? I nearly had a heart attack, okay? A lung attack, a liver attack, arm attack. I've almost had my whole body attacked, okay? Not only by my stress, but by a gigantic rocket beetle. I'm not meant for LA living, okay? I'm moving back home. To the good old country. Sacramento. What if those gigantic IKEA building beetles just fly into my windows when I'm sleeping at night and just crawl up all in my mouth? Okay, why am I talking about it? Why am I freaking myself out? I thought LA was the land of hopes and dreams, not the land of gigantic Demogorgon beetles flying in cars when I'm driving, okay? Y'all trying to make me wreck my house. You know what I just realized? That beetle survived raid, okay? Not once. Two times, okay? Two good ones. I gave him two good ones. He survived, okay? Flew away. That's scary, okay? He saw my license plate. He knows who I am. I have to move. No one's safe from gigantic megalodon beetles. Catch the movie The Meg in theaters. I don't know what it's in theaters. I don't even care. Don't go watch the movie. It's probably stupid. Okay, bye. I think the autocorrect on my phone is making me dumb. Either that, or it's just showing me how dumb I really am. Either way, I don't like it. It took me literally 15 tries to get the word calendar right, okay? First off, autocorrect couldn't even help me there. They didn't even know what I was trying to say, okay? I was so far off, my autocorrect was like, we don't know. At least start with the right letter, okay? C-A-L. First off, autocorrect didn't even know what I was trying to say, okay? They couldn't even help me no more. All three spaces at the top, they went blank. It was just emojis, like, just thinking emojis. They didn't even know. They were at a loss. I was at a loss. C-A-L. That's as far as I got, okay? C-A-L-A-C-A calendar or calander? Depends on what part of Arkansas you're from. C-A-L-A-C, C-A-L, is it a C? Oh my God. Some of those suggestions that they make are hilarious, okay? Way off. For instance, on Father's Day, I messaged my grandpa, okay? I said, love you, Grandpa. Happy Father's Day, okay? And then, you know, things come up. An emoji of a heart. Emoji of like a gift. And then an emoji of a man's face. A black man's face. That was the emoji that it recommended for me to send to my grandpa, who is not black, very not black. What information have I given my iPhone to lead it to believe that my grandpa is black? I don't know. It has literally been 7 years since I've spelled a word out in its entirety, okay? Sometimes I'm amazed at how good the iPhone is at predicting the words. Sometimes I won't even start with the right three letters, completely off, and they're like, you're an idiot. This is what you're trying to say. And I'm like, oh yeah. You know what I can't spell now? The word definitely. I don't think I have ever spelt the word definitely right the first time on my phone, okay? And then autocorrect comes in and is like, hey stupid, spell like this. You're spelling defiantly. I am a full grown man, okay? I am 27 years old. I should be able to spell definitely. I definitely should be able to spell definitely. But you know what? I definitely cannot spell definitely. D-E-F-I-D-I-E-I or y'all don't make fun of me right now, okay? Go to your phone and spell definitely without autocorrect. You can't do it. It's impossible. Nobody knows how to spell it, okay? No, I am not smarter than a fifth grader, okay? Wrong. I meant to spell defiantly, iPhone, okay? I defiantly want to go to the country concert with you tonight, okay? Defiantly, exclamation point, exclamation point. C-A-L. It's embarrassing, okay? It's like, y'all know when you're watching Netflix with all your friends and stuff at your house, and then, like, someone's like, hey, let's watch Definitely Maybe. And you're like, yeah, good idea, good movie. But then you have to type it in on the little letter by letter, and there's no autocorrect on Netflix. Not on the TV. We already know I can't spell definitely. No, we're watching defiantly, maybe. I don't want to be stupid no more. S-T-U-P-E-D. I still got it. I do not know what to do with my arms when I'm just standing still. You can't just stop walking and keep your arms moving, okay? That's weird. People are going to film you, put you on YouTube. You're going to go viral for all the wrong reasons, okay? Like, when I'm standing still and my arms are just at my side, I feel the most awkward I've ever felt in my life. Why do I feel like people are looking at what my arms are doing? People barely watch my videos that I create, let alone watching what my arms do when I'm standing at a crosswalk. Why can't I just stand still and let my arms hang naturally? No, I can't, because I'm thinking about them. It's kind of like when you realize that you're breathing, and then now you can't breathe regular for the next 10 to 15 minutes. Being aware of your arms is the problem. Don't be aware of your arms. If you were to take anything away from this video, it's that. Sometimes it's awkward when I'm walking, okay? If I start to notice my arms are there, then it's awkward. I'm like, does the left one go with the left foot, or does it go opposite of the left foot and it comes back? Do I bend my elbows? I know it's late, but I was craving ice cream real bad, okay? Went to McDonald's, got me an Oreo McFlurry, okay? Sounded real good till they handed me this, okay? You see that? The heck I'm gonna do with that? Maybe I'm losing it. Didn't they used to stir that in? Isn't that why y'all have that weird looking straw right there, that doohickey right there? Plugs it in, stirs it for you? Half the fun of eating a McFlurry is the fact that it's already mixed in, okay? It did nothing, okay? My ice cream is probably melting at this point. I wouldn't know because it's covered up by Oreos that aren't mixed into my ice cream. Y'all know I got ants, right? I can't be slinging Oreos all over my car. Y'all know that, okay? I get it. Sometimes that machine goes down all the time every day. But did your arm go down? No, because you handed it to me with your arm. Which you could have stirred my Oreo into my ice cream with that same arm. I'm just saying, I notice things, okay? I also noticed that I paid full price for it. I also ordered breakfast burritos, okay? It's breakfast somewhere. It's basically the same thing as y'all handing me a flour tortilla and then, like, sausage, egg, and cheese on the side and say, y'all want me to assemble my own breakfast burrito? Stir in my Oreo! It does taste better. I'm filming. It does taste better knowing that I did the majority of the work here. Okay, even though they didn't stir in my Oreos, this is still delicious, okay? Straight delicious. Not only did I have to wait in line for 20 minutes because the guy in front of me wanted an extreme coupon from his phone with invalid coupons from 2012, but I had to stir in my own Oreos. Maybe it was her first day. I don't know. But she slid that McFlurry across the table towards me like she knew what she was doing, okay? She was like, number 252, look me right in the eyeballs. She knew I knew. She knew, okay? We knew each other knew each other knew. I knew it, okay? I look right back at her and I said, you're not done yet, okay? I'll take these burritos. You take the McFlurry. Finish it. Then pass it back to me. Set all that up here, okay? As I grabbed my Oreo McFlurry, but the Oreos piled on top because I don't like confrontation. I realize that ice cream at 11 o'clock at night isn't the healthiest. But I did have a workout before, okay? So I should be okay. And it's not just the fact that she didn't stir in my Oreos. She also gave me my change back in all quarters. $5. She gave me 20 quarters, okay? What am I gonna do with 20 quarters? Put them in my pocket, okay? Pants nearly fell to the floor as I walked back to my car, okay? Gonna have to buy a belt to hold up all my quarters. Am I a little PO'd? Yeah, a little. Am I gonna come back to this McDonald's? Yeah, a little. Oh, I'm not stopping the video until I eat my whole entire McFlurry, okay? Y'all just gonna have to wait. McDonald's, I know you're gonna watch this video, okay? Because I'm amazing. You probably follow me. I would, if I were me. I do, because I am me. But, if you're watching this, is this a new update? Is this like something you're doing now? Y'all making people work? I get it. Y'all making people work before they eat. That way, the obesity levels go down so people can't tie that kind of stuff to y'all. Y'all are smart. I figured it out, though, so you're not that smart, but I mean it. It is pretty smart. McDonald's, if you're watching this, I demand free The heck just happened? Spontaneous combustions? As I was saying, before science happened, I think a good repayment would be free McFlurries for life. Stirred, please. Dear Lord. If y'all give me free McFlurries for life and it's just piled on top, I don't want that, okay? Y'all can put that straight in the trash. That's where I should have put this instead of put it straight in my mouth. Thank you, McDonald's, for a very mediocre experience yet again. I will be back tomorrow night for another McFlurry. Y'all, I had a dream about ants last night. Y'all know what that means? That means not only is my reality infested with ants, but so is my dream state. Update number 3. The ants are in my walls. I thought I had got rid of all these ants, but I've been wrong before. So what is happening now is the ants are finding their way inside the doors, inside the walls, like in things. They're finding... The ants are in my walls. Okay? I don't know how else to tell y'all, but the ants are in my walls. They are no longer infesting the inside of my car. They are inside the inside of my car. Okay? They are inception ants. Okay? They are literally inside the inside of my car. I don't know how to get rid of ants when they're on the inside of the car. I don't even know how to get into the inside of my car, okay? I didn't even comprehend the fact that I had the inside of an inside of a car until I saw a mess load of ants go into the inside of my car. They're in the doors. I just opened the passenger door over here. I didn't see no ants, okay? Normally people would be like, that's a good sign. No, it's not. I know they're here. It's just they found a better hiding spot than I can find. I scared him right out the wall. Now he's trying to crawl up the window like I ain't gonna roll it down on him and squish him. He don't know me. The problem is a whole new generation of ants have been born into my car, okay? Into the doors. So they have no idea my killing power. So they just come out whenever they want, thinking this is their place, which they're wrong. And then they die at an early, early age, which is sad. But it's also sad that I have to kill baby ants because their parents aren't smart enough to tell them. That ginger white boy's gonna kill you. An ant just came right out of my planter, okay? There's also a couple dead ants on that planter. You know what that means? They're planning something. Holy crap. I really appreciate all y'all who've been telling me like ways to get rid of these ants. You guys are like the best, okay? For all you who haven't given me any advice on how to get rid of these ants, don't worry, I'm gonna send all y'all a care package, okay? Yeah. Inside that care package, however, is going to be a camcorder and about a bazillion ants, okay? The ants are going to flock into your home, okay? Or wherever you live, I don't know. And then the camcorder is going to record everything that's happened. I'm going to see how you get rid of the ants, and I'm going to use that knowledge, okay? I think I did the most serial killer thing in my entire life last night. Last night, I didn't feel like recording a video, so I just sat here, okay? And then there was an ant on my door. Okay, fair enough. They're everywhere. But I started talking to this ant, okay? Human conversation. I started communicating with the ant, okay? That's not all. After about the 10-minute conversation, I gave this ant a name, okay? I named the ant, and then I killed it. Maybe these ants are just showing me my true colors, okay? My colors just so happen to be, like, serial killer black. Who attaches themselves to something by having a 10-minute conversation with it and then kills it? Hey, I'm losing my mind, okay? I haven't had peanut butter in days. Withdrawals, it's killing me, okay? I miss my bread. There's something crawling on my leg. I bet you $10 I can guess exactly what it is. What if I become like a hoarder? And instead of cats, I keep ants. I don't know. Things happen. People are weird. What if I get to the point where I can't fall asleep unless I have ants all over my body? Okay? People get there, okay? Things like this change people. I'm going through a life-changing experience. I'm just trying to change for the better, okay? I need to change the ants. So the ants don't change me, okay? I'm gonna start playing, oh my Lord, I figured it out. I figured out why they're so aggressive. All I do is play heavy metal in my car. Dear Lord, I'm priming the new babies coming into this world to be aggressive little metal ants, okay? Oh my Lord, what? From now on, I'm only going to play motivational tapes. Who have I become? A killing machine, that's what. What if all these ants were just watching my videos and they all were fans and they just wanted to come meet me? What if they thought this was a meet and greet? Oh my God, I killed all my fans. To the 700 fans left, I'm sorry. But be thankful I didn't kill y'all too, okay? I'm just on this killing spree of killing people who enjoy my content. I'm done. No more. No more killing. Please let me kill this one. I bet he didn't even watch my stuff anyway. He's just a bandwagon. My car's dirty. How can y'all ants live in this pigsty? If y'all gonna stay, at least clean up a bit, okay? Wipe something down. I don't care. Y'all strong enough to carry my shoes away? Y'all can lift a rag. I'm sorry if y'all are getting tired of these ant updates, but I vlog about my life, okay? Just so happens that only thing happening in my life is being infested by ants in my car. So, sorry. Not sorry. Kind of. Not really. I might... No, I'm not. I am. Kidding. Love y'all. I do. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. Yeah, okay. Not okay. It's okay. Stop. This isn't funny anymore. It's pretty funny. I'm not laughing. But I am, though. Okay. Bye. Bye. So the other day, I was getting all emotional for no reason, and I don't know why. I got emotional watching the movie The Tooth Fairy. Yeah. The one with the rock, where he becomes a tooth fairy. Yeah, that one. It was at the part at the end where the boy was on stage at the talent show doing his guitar thing. He did real good, standing ovation. And then The Rock looks over at the woman he's with and he's like, maybe we should get married. One up in the kid on the stage. Now the mom no longer cares about her son. She only cares about Mr. Hunk of Muscles over here. I don't think anyone in the world has ever cried at that part in that movie, okay? Because I'm not sure that anyone's even made it that far into the movie without, like, the heck, why am I watching this? Change the channel, okay? That was emotional incident number one, okay? Emotional incident number two happened when I was on Facebook, okay? It was a guy singing, Callum Scott, I don't remember his name, okay? I was too busy crying. He came on, he started singing, I started crying, okay? I don't even know why. I didn't understand the lyrics one bit. Was he talking to a guy? Was he talking to a girl? Who knows? I don't know. I don't care. I didn't even attach it to any memory in my life. It just made me want to cry. What is happening to me? Is the moon closer? I lost it, okay? I was doing that thing where you're trying to hold back tears, and it's, but it's like in your throat. Somehow the tears are in your throat. They ain't even up to your eyeballs yet. So I'm just trying to hold it back, and I'm like doing that number, okay? Because I'm with a bunch of guys, okay? I'm not going to show weakness around these guys, okay? Because then they're going to attack me, okay? That's what we do. You cry, you die, okay? I made that up, but that semi-accurate, okay? Dear Lord, if the movie Radio would have came on that day, I would have solved the California drought crisis, okay? That's how much I would have cried. I think having all these ants in my car has gotten me emotional, okay? They're changing me somehow. They're softening my heart, and or they're eating away at it. I don't know. Something's happening to this blood pumper right here that I can't explain, okay? What's happening to me? Menopause? I was hot today. I don't do good with spicy things, okay? My ethnicity should already tell you that. Last week, I was at work, okay? And one of the people who worked at the night shift came in, but they brought food in, okay? I was like, good. Starving. I can't wait. What you got, okay? So they laid out this a buffet of food, okay, all over the table. And it looks so good. Oh, it looked good, and I was ready to eat it, okay? Some of y'all may understand this, but some of y'all may have no idea what I'm talking about. But they brought this sauce in, okay? All I gotta do is tell you what container this sauce was in, okay? This sauce was in a Betty Crocker butter container. That's how hot you know it is, okay? I took a look at that container and I said, I know what you are, okay? I know the devil has many disguises, okay? And that's one of them. No Mexican woman has ever put a sauce inside of a country crock butter container unless that sauce tasted like the sun feels, okay? I don't know exactly the Scoville unit of this sauce. If I had to guess, I would guess the most. Let me try my best, okay, to explain to you how hot this sauce was. I saw the butter container and I said, Satan's in there. They tried to feed me devil's anger, okay? That's what I've named the sauce already, okay? They tried to feed me this devil's anger sauce, okay? But they prefaced it by saying, oh, it's not spicy. First off, you're sweating, okay? Juan, you're sweating. And when Juan is sweating, that means, oh, white face here is probably gonna die. I've dated enough Mexican girls, okay? I think I can handle the spice. I grab a chip. I scoop up that sauce. I put it 2 inches away from my mouth, okay? My mouth, it's hovering. It ain't in my mouth yet. It's hovering in my mouth, and my lips are on fire. The vapor of this sauce, okay, hovering 2 inches from my lips, is immediately chapping my lip. And before I continue, I just want to say that I have the worst friends in the world. They're horrible. I hate them. Guy, one of my friends pushed it to where it went into my mouth a little bit, okay? I had it hovering right here, okay? My lips are already chapped. I had it hovering. He hit my hand. It went in my mouth, hit my lips a little bit. Let the hell begin. This sauce was one of those sauces that just, boom, hit you, okay? I scared you a little bit, I could tell. But the sauce scared me too, okay? Y'all know my white mouth can't take spicy things, okay? Why would you push that chip into my mouth? I am now starting to sweat, okay, internally. My body is sweating from the inside, I can feel it. I was hallucinating the whole time, okay? All I saw was tiny little Mexican men with sombreros, okay? That's how hot this sauce was. It was changing my perception of reality, okay? All the little prep ladies turned into tiny little Mexican men with sombreros, okay? Just with a el mocolete, just making all kinds of spicy sauces for me to put in my mouth. I was having trouble speaking, okay? Any words that were coming out were fluent Spanish. I understood them too, okay? My mind was on fire, my mouth was on fire. I literally turned into a Mexican for 3.5 minutes, okay? My unique shade of white started to turn a nice golden brown, okay? I decided to work real hard at my job, actually. I was thinking of accordion melodies in my head when I got home so I could play. I don't have an accordion, never played, never touched one. I knew how to dance merengue at that point, okay? I just started dancing, okay? Bachata, everything came to me, okay? It's like I knew. It's like that pill Limitless, when you take it, you just know. It's like that, but the Mexican version, and it's just spice, okay? Spice on a chip, that's the pill. And then you have all these Mexican powers, okay? For 3.5 minutes, I had Mexican powers, except for one. The ability to eat spicy food, okay? That never comes over to my side of the, no, okay? I can't. And the worst part about eating spicy foods is when all this goes away, when the numbness goes away and all, you're done coughing and crying and sweating, you're not done, okay? Because it's got to come out somehow. And when it comes out, you're going to do all of those things, but in reverse. Luckily, after about 10.5 minutes, I came to, okay? I came back into my white form, and everything was good again, okay? And then they tried to offer me another chip. Stop offering me spicy foods. My white mouth can't take it. I'm tired of having Mexican powers. I'll take a Butterfinger or something, okay? Did y'all know people are still wearing their pants where they're hanging off their butt cheeks? I was walking into Target so I could buy this here Rockstar Energy Pop and this one Goldfish. There was a guy in front of me, okay, and his back pockets were touching the floor. He realized that he didn't lock his car doors because he turned around and started reaching for his keys, except his pockets were further than his arm could reach. I see some of y'all judging me, okay, for sounding old, unrelatable, wrong. I used to do it too, okay, when I was like 12, and all I wanted to do was fit in. The only thing I want to fit in nowadays is my pants to my waist, okay? I realize that there may be a situation where some kid got hand-me-downs that are way too big and he can't even afford a belt, okay? I understand that. But when you're wearing elastic ball shorts and they're just attached to the mid-thigh, I don't think they're called ball shorts anymore now, are they?
Please say a command after the beep. Available command. To slow down time.
Yeah.
gonna fall asleep recording this video. I already know. I can tell the future. It's gonna happen. It has happened. I've fallen asleep. Did I just fall asleep? Y'all, I'm so tired. Ever since I got into this rental car, I haven't slept. Cover your ears. This car is so uncomfortable, okay? I can't sleep in this thing. This little one-night stand, this weak fling, don't mean nothing, okay? I miss my baby, my real deal, okay? And I'm gonna uncover her ears. We're gonna continue this conversation, okay? Like I was saying, she's the greatest car. Today's my day off. I was like, good. Gonna catch up on some sleep. Gonna mustard on some sleep, too. Every kind of condiment on sleep. Put all of them on my sleep, okay? Shut up. So I park, okay? I park. I leave the car running because it's 106 degrees. And I start to sleep. I'm starting to drift. I feel it, okay? My body's going. Yes, Lord. Take me. I feel your presence and your gifts. And then I hear a knock on my window, and it's parking enforcement. Were they worried that I was sleeping in my car or worried that I was parked for too long? No. They thought I was dead, okay? Knocked on my window. Which, if you're homeless, that's the worst sound you can possibly hear. It makes my heart jump just listening to it, okay? I'm literally 5.5 inches away from falling asleep. Hear that on my window, okay? Naturally, I'm awake. My blood is pumping, okay? Now I can't even sleep if I wanted to. He was worried that I had passed out because I left my car running with my windows up. I was like, that's how cars work. You leave your windows up, you have the air running, you're not gonna die. Why do I have to explain this to you? Are you the devil? He interrupted my sleep. I was... this close to falling asleep, okay? I felt it too. I was there, okay? I was at the pearly gates, okay? Me and Peter did our sweet, sweet handshake we came up with. And I was about to walk into the gates of heaven, okay? But before that, Satan called. Maybe I was dying. Maybe I thought I was about to fall asleep, but maybe I was just dying. Either way, I wish I would have just died. Could have got some sleep. It's bad, y'all. I'm forgetting things, okay? I'd give you an example, but I forgot all my examples, okay? I'm literally falling asleep at the wheel of life. I just won't sleep, okay? My body's starting to shut down. I'm not hungry no more, okay? I can't eat. This is the reason I'm still awake, okay? This is also the reason why I'm not gonna go to sleep later, okay? It's a vicious cycle. My mind starts racing and thinking of weird things. Like, why the heck does Ben and Jerry not have a Neapolitan ice cream called Gay Pride? Maybe I'll fall asleep, maybe I won't. It's basically how decisions work. Except now I'm not in control of my body, okay? My heart's just pounding away because I drank a Red Bull because I was falling asleep while doing laundry. I ended up buying a lottery ticket. I don't buy lottery tickets. I won, okay? Tripled my money. But then I gave it to a homeless lady. I'm obviously super nice when I'm tired, okay? I can't sleep in a parking lot because some parking instructor guy's going to come in and say, hey, you dead? No. You're going to be. You wake me up one more again, okay? Don't do that. I don't like that. This, you can stop that right now, okay? I have a gigantic blemish. Don't look. I think this is from lack of sleep. I don't have any, like, scientific findings to back up my hypothesis, but I'm pretty sure this is from a lack of sleep. Maybe I can sleep with one eye open. Or just close them both, I don't care. If I blink too long, I'll fall asleep. But then I won't be able to fall asleep. Because my mind's creating new Ben and Jerry's ice cream flavors.
Thinking about that gay pride Ben and Jerry's ice cream flavor that I created, I think people might get upset. Because the way the circles work, if you cut it into three equal portions, the middle's always going to be bigger. And the middle's always the color white. People are going to blame Trump because Ben and Jerry's put white in the center and it's bigger than the chocolate and the strawberry. You know what? This is what my mind is thinking about with lack of sleep. I think the reason why I'm not sleeping is also because of my diet, which is literally nothing. And then some sugar, okay? I had a Danish for lunch. A Danish, okay? You know what I didn't have for lunch? A nap. And now I'm considering going to get ice cream. You know what? I'm gonna go try to sleep. I'm gonna try my best. Sun's going down, it's getting cooler. It's a brisk 97 degrees outside, bless him, Lord. Maybe I'll be able to sleep this blemish away. Doubtful. It looks pretty permanent. Cállate, cabrón. Estoy cansado. It's like they don't understand fluent Spanish. Okay, bye. Y'all hear that? I just laid down to take a nap. Okay? Who in the world is starting a chainsaw at 8 o'clock at night and why? Okay? Why and who? Who and why? What is happening? Where? This man better be making giant... I got nothing, okay? Just bless him, Lord. Because I'm going to throw a shoe off this balcony and try to hit him square in the face. As some of y'all know, my car was in the shop because she picked up smoking, okay? Bad habit. Made her quit. They called me today. And they said, we're sorry. She's going to need a lung transplant. God dang it. Her little radiator went out because she'd been smoking too much, okay? That's what smoking does to y'all. Kids, listen up, okay? Unless y'all want to break your radiator, don't smoke, okay? Bad habit. So I called them right back, and I said, I'll do it, okay? I'll donate my lung. I'll do it. And they said, no, you won't, because you're not a perfect match, okay? Because it's a car, and you're human. You're money. Just give us money. We'll fix it. I said, that works, too. How much? I'll pay anything. They said, it's only going to be $1,000. I said, how much? Like, maybe I didn't hear them right the first time. $1,000 is a little ridiculous, okay? So I said, no. Let me come take a look real quick, okay? Because I know how some mechanics are. They say something's wrong when it's not, okay? I go there. I lift the hood, okay? I'm looking. And then I just point, okay? What is that? And they're like, that's the engine. And I said, okay, change the radiation thing. I don't know cars, okay? Every time I go to a drive-thru and then I pull up to the window to pay and the people there are always on their little headset thing, I can never tell if they're talking to me or if they're talking to the person ordering behind me. I can't tell, okay? Half the time they're staring directly into my eyeballs. How are you gonna expect me not to think you're talking to me if your eyeballs are talking to me, okay? If your eyeballs are talking to me, then I'm assuming your mouth is talking to me. Yeah! Of course I think you're talking to me. You're making direct eye contact, okay? You haven't broken this gaze since I pulled up to window number 2. I'm either going to need you to take that gaze of yours and go direct it somewhere else, maybe go look at a stack of styrofoam cups or something like that, or you could just direct my tacos to my face and I'll leave, okay? I pull up to the second window She says your total's gonna be 367. Okay. Where's my card? Please, charge it. I always charge my tacos. I'm in a tough spot right now, okay? I see you judging my situation. Stop that. Don't look directly at me unless you want me to directly reply to what you just said. And then, when she was handing me my bag of tacos, which I'm rummaging through right now, can't find one. Ordered six, I should be able to. Found one, here's one. When she was handing me my bag of tacos through the window, she looked directly into my baby blues, and she said, "Thank you. Pull around to the first window." Y'all, I'm already at the second window, okay? I have already surpassed the place where she wants me to go. She wants me to go around, okay, pass, go, collect $200, come back around to the first window. For what? I got my food. Can I just leave? I said, can we just do it here? Okay? That's the first thing that came to my head. I know that's weird. Out of context. With context, it's weird. Shut up. I thought I handled it great. Can we just do it here? You know, I'm mature about it. I'm thinking for the both of us. Maybe she didn't think this plan all the way through. She wants me to go to the first window. I'm already at the second one. Let's just knock it out here, do our transaction, and I'll leave. Until she said, "What?" And then I was like, I'm an idiot. I had already got my food. All I had to do was drive away. For some reason, I enjoy making things extremely awkward. "Thank you. Please pull around to the first window." Why can't we just do it here? Perfectly good conversation if she were talking to me. You're not even at the first window. I don't understand what kind of transaction is going to happen when I go to the first window. We're here. We're here right now, okay? Living the moment. I thought that last taco was the flimsiest taco in the world, y'all. This is just like a fish. Look at this. Look at that. Y'all think y'all looking at a fish. That's a taco. It's stuck to the bag. Do I just throw it away? Do I just give up? Or do I just keep chasing pavement, okay? I demand a refund. I ain't coming to get it. So that means I'll have to go around to the first window, which is exactly what she wants me to do. I ain't gonna do it, okay? What if she would agreed to me saying, can't we just do it here? Me not knowing what it is, and her having no idea, just thinking I'm coming on to her. That would have got me in a whole mess of trouble, okay? I don't think it would go nowhere. Then again, could have gone everywhere. Look at my baby blues. Irresistible. It's like those people who used to wear those little Bluetooth things to answer their phone. So y'all are sitting in the car and they answer the phone. And they're like, how you doing? So you respond, I'm good, Dad. How are you doing? There's only two of you in the car. I can only assume you're talking to me. Then they do that little... So you don't care how I'm doing, or you want me to go around to the first window, Dad? I don't know what you want from me. I don't think my dad talked to me my whole entire childhood. I think he was just on the phone and I was just responding the whole time. That would mean he has a son somewhere else that he's very proud of and loves. Good for him.